I pronounce to everyone here. I'm sure my co-artists will also agree with me when I say our hearts are filled with a divine feeling to be performing here, which has taken on its head the holy dust on the feet of Shankara. Not all will be blessed with this kind of an opportunity. I just submit at the lotus feet of Lord Shankara whatever I have to sing today. Please consider this as my very, very humble offering, whatever I do, with absolutely no sense of pride in it. I am asked to sing a few compositions in praise of Shankara and a few in praise of Lakshmi, who graced this place with a shower of golden gooseberries. To begin with, I have the very popular, well-known item by Mahavaidyanatha Shivan in Radha Nadaswaravali, which extols the greatness of a great seer. Sa-shankar-atipati-bana-jala-tula-kala-anaram. The flow is so good. Sa-shankar, he is also not very sure of his success. That Ratipati, Manmatha, when he comes to thwart the penance of Shiva, he is almost certain of his death rather than success. So Sa-shankar, he has his own shanka, doubt. Ratipati, Manmatha, his bana, jala, tula, his network of arrows, which is should be considered as a heap of cotton, tula, for which our Shankara is like Kalanara, the one who had risen above all passion, one who had perfect total control over his senses. It was like a heap of cotton. So he was like the Kalanara, the destructive fire. Ajnana Timira Tarani, he is the boat to navigate through the Timira, the darkness of Ajnana, ignorance. Angikrita Shruti Sarani, he had accepted, he had taken into his system the entire Shruti Sarani series of the Vedas. Sugnana Sukha Dharanim or Sukha Taranim. There are two versions, both are right. Sugnana Sukha Tarani. Tarani is again a boat. Sukha Dharanim, that is the one who is the abode of Sugnana. And that Sugnana rested, resided, dwelt in him as if it's his, its own home. Sukha. Sukshma Pranava Aranim. He is like the Arani or the fire stick rubbing which we get the fire. For the Sukshma Pranava or the Omkara, the Sukshmati Sukshma Bindu Nada. So he is like the Sukshma Pranava Aranim. Shri Shankara Guru Varam Chintayani Santatam. So this composition we begin today's concert with. Thank you. சங்கர குருவரும் Oh, Next is a very, very special and extremely rare composition. Perhaps no one here would have heard. Till very recently, it was also considered as a composition of Mahavaidyanatha Shivan, because in the last charana, we have Vaidyanatha coming in that. But it was after thorough research by one of my very good friends, Vidushi Padma Gurudar, we came to know that it is by an Asthana Vidwan called Vaidyanatha Shivan, who was a Vidwan during the times of Nrisimha Bharati Swami. He has composed it on Shankaracharya. Shankara Guruvara Mahima, it's in chaste Sanskrit, very beautiful Sanskrit. Shankara Guruvara Mahima Sutaram Atitarati Vang Manasa Simam. Guru Charana Bhakti Garima Mukharayati Taram Ki Mukakalpam Mam. It is like Mukam Karoti Vachari. I am like a Muka, I don't know anything. It is only the Guru Bhakti that has made me eloquent. Guru Charana Bhakti Mahima Mukharayati Taram Ki Mukakalpam Mam. Goes on, I don't want to explain it. It is in actually 11 ragas. It is a ragamalika, it's a colossal composition with very beautiful chitta swaras in between, set to Aditala. It is actually in 11 ragas, but in the end, he says, Navaratna Malikeyam Rachita Bhaktena Vaidyanathena. I take it as Navaratna Malika, it does not refer to the number of ragas. It is like the 9 gems, as precious as great as the gems. So this beautiful Malika of gems, the Navaratna, it is composed by Vaidyanatha, that is the claim in the end. We have both traditional and not so traditional ragas like Behar. We have a Kamaj coming in with Todi, Bhairavi, Saranga, then Shankarabharana, Suruti, starting with Dhanyasi, Shahana. So these are the ragas. I hope you really enjoy both the lyric and the music and the structure. Unlike the one I sang, there is no viloma. It just goes in one direction and comes back at the, towards the end to Pallavi in Raga Dhanyasi. Oh,
Yeah. Ah
we are going to sing a few compositions. Composed in praise of Goddess Mahalakshmi by Dikshita. Access to all forms of music of the world. His compositions have assimilated the best in different systems of music. If he takes Hindustani music, Uttaradi Sangeeta, he brings it to the mould and fold of Carnatic classical with a touch of the flourishes now and then, just to make us feel that yes, it is something different. But it is well within the frame of Carnatic music, where nowhere does he exceed the limits. And that requires enormous talent, not just talent, it is he alone can do it. No other composer has done this wonder. We have a tendency to be carried away by anything that is foreign. We don't know what to take. We don't have a sieve with us. But he had a golden sieve with him. So, through which he got only that which was required, that which he felt should give a different dimension to our music. We speak of creativity today, we speak of modernism today, we speak of admixtures of different systems today, but how it should be done, here is a model. If we study the compositions of Dikshita in the right perspective, then we certainly realize the greatest virtue of strengthening the roots with fresh fruits. With fresh sprouts, the roots have to be firm. If the roots are not firm, we are most certain to fall, swept off our feet. Our feet have to be fixed firmly to the ground, and then alone we can extend our arms to different corners. That's what our Upanishads say, Ano Bhadra Kratavo Yentu Vishvataha. From every corner let noble thoughts pour. So what these noble thoughts are, we must learn from Dikshita. This lengthy introduction, I am extremely sorry for.
You
because I am so much pained these days, sometimes by the atrocious onslaught of some foreign elements on our deep classical music. So how far we are able to stop it, we are not sure. At least we let us know what is ours and truly ours, and how it is given to improvisation, how we are ready to take something that is good for us in the right measure and in the right spirit. So here is an instance. We are going to sing Neerajakshi Kamakshi. If you want to say it is Hindola, it is Hindola. If you want to call it something like Malkaus, call it. Dikshita doesn't object to it. Because the way he has used the notes with the lighter shade of it, with the Digujaru, the Jaru meaning the Damakas that occur very often in Hindustani music, he lends it a different flavor altogether. The color is totally different. It is something exotic, so we should be able to enjoy that with a stress more on Madhyama and Nishada. I just would like to draw your attention to how he has used the link between the bridge between Madhyama and Nishada. Throughout he uses that Madhyama, from Ma he swings to Nishada. What a beautiful concept. And about the lyric, Neerajakshi Kamakshi Neerada Chipure, I think very special. Till we come to Kamakshi itself, So a great guru in Mysore, he told me how the significance of the word Kamakshi. Ka, Hraswa is Brahman, Brahma. Ka, the Sri Rupa, Sri Linga of that represents Saraswati. Ma is Vishnu, whereas Ma is Lakshmi. So Ka, Ma, Shi, Akshi. Sharada Rama Nayane. Dikshita uses this. Sharada is Saraswati, Rama is Lakshmi, the one Kamakshi who has Ka and Ma as her eyes. Sharada and Rama Nayane. Sarasa Chantranane. Varijapade Varade Tarayamam Tattvapade. Gauri Hindola Dyuti. Heera Mani Maya Bharade. Gauri Hindola Dyuti. That is, it's a beautiful what you call the dancing of the Dyuti. And it is bright in shape. So it is the dangling of her Abharanas. Heera Mani Maya. Heera is Vajra. Heera Mani Maya Bharade. Shauri Virinchi. Virinchi Indradi Sannuta Navavarane Nari Manyadhyarchita Navanathantakarane Surijana Samsevita Sundara Guru Guha Karane. With a very beautiful Chitraswara. It is Chitraswara, we call it Chitteswara. We have made it Chitteswara. Chitra is that attractive combination of swaras which is appended to the sahitya. So with a very brief alapana, today I am not going to do much of manodharma.
Yeah.
स्वराक्षर
Oh,
Saying that he has no regard for Manava Janma. Hina Manava, he calls Manavas Hina, which is very, 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 very wrong. He did not call Manavas Hina, he called Manava Ashraya Hina, which is the Ashraya of Manavas, which he doesn't want to, because there is Hiranmayi, Lakshmi. So Manava Ashraya is Hina. No one for that matter who has self-dignity and self-respect, self-esteem, should beg before others or should accept alms and craving to be favored by people. If she favors, she fails. She has to do it. The goddess of well, when she is there, when I am her devotee, it is her responsibility to take care of all my earthly needs. If she does not give, I don't mind. So, Hiranmayim Lakshmi, that is why he uses the word Hiranya. Hiranmayim, she is, how much gold you want, how much wealth you want, how much riches, affluence you want, she is the very embodiment of that. Hiranmayim Lakshmi Bhajami, Manava Hinashrayam Yajami. That is the idea. Not Hina Manava, Hinashrayam. Hina Manava Ashrayam Yajami. Chiratara Sampat Pradhan. If she gives, Lakshmi is Chanchala, they say always. But if she really makes up her mind to be with you, what she gives is eternal wealth. Chiratara Sampat Pradhan. Kshiram Budhitanayam. Hari Vakshasthalalayam. Hari Neem Charana Kisalayam. Kara Kamala Dhrita Kuvalayam. Marakata Manimaya Valayam Hiranmayim Lakshmim. How much Abharana do you want? The flora and fauna, the natural and the man-made Abharana, whatever you can think of, she is decked with them. Shweta Dvipa Vasinim. Again, from which the Mysore saint gave me a very beautiful explanation. It is the Palkadal, Shweta Dvipa. Shvetadvipa Vasinim Sri Kamalambikam Param Bhuta Bhavya Vilasinim Bhusura Pujitam Varam Mataram Abjamalinim Manikya Bharana Dharam Girita Vadya Vinodinim Girijam Tam Indiram. She is Girija also. Girijam Tam Indira Indiram Shita Kirana Nibhavadanam Shrita Chintamani Sadanam Pita Vasanam Guruha Matula Kantam Dalitam. Guruha's Matula, maternal uncle, is Vishnu. His wife, his consort. Guruha Matula Kantam Dalitam Hiranmayim Lakshmiim Bhajami Hiramana Vashrayam Tejam. And he uses, employs, I don't say uses, he employs most judiciously the best suited Lalita Raga, which all Komala Bhava. She is Shweta Dvipa Vasini, and she is Lalita, and she is Chita Kirana Nibhavadana. So Chandra Sahodari she is. All about her is so cool and calm and pleasant. And if she minds, it is she alone who can bring peace of mind. Chandrama Manaso Jata. So, the Chandra Sodari alone has the ability to bring peace of mind to us. That calmness, that coolness, unperturbed, undisturbed mind, even at times of lack of, that is, physical wealth or whatever. So this is the kind of balance of mind. If she gives, she need not give only material wealth. If she minds, she can give us the beautiful mind to take everything in a very cool and calm way. That's what Dikshita did. So in this composition, he speaks his mind as to what should be one's attitude in this life regarding earthly possessions. Here again, the sancharas are very beautifully meandering. So it is just sliding and gliding from one note to another without any hazard, without any jerks. But at the same time there is that substance, and because he is emphatic when he says Hina Mana Vashrayam Tyajami. Music, if it can be used this way to enhance the effect, impact of the meaning, nothing like that. The experience is something ethereal and beyond words. Yeah. किरणमयी लक्ष्मी सदा भजामि Yeah. a Vilamma Adi, but in a very majestic gait, with a tempo that is lively, at the same time dignified. Has depth at the same time. The 32 aksharas of an Adi Tala, which are called Radanakshara Samyukta. Rada, 32 teeth we have. So an Adi Tala is described as Radanakshara Samyukta. So all the 32 teeth are actively participating. That is, the whole mouth is actively participating in the evenly in a Vilambakala Adi Tala. So this is again Kamakshi Varalakshmi, Kamalakshi Jayalakshmi, Kamajanaka Purna Phale Saphale, Kamitartha Dayini Shri Phale, all phalas, Kamakale Vimale Karakamale, Kamakoti Vilaharinuta Kamale, Dinakara Koti Prakashakaye Dedipyamana Divyachaye Vanajasanadi Vanditamaye Vasudeva Parabrahma Jaye. Vishnu is Parabrahma Swarupa. Parabrahma Jaye. Best part. Manana Dhyana Dhyatra Dhyeye Mahaniya Samrajya Pradaye Sanaka Sanandanadi Virgyeye Sadaye Sarasa Guru Guha Sahaye Kamakshi Varalakshmi. This is a Shuddha Bilahari with no Kaishiki Nishadha.
Da 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 da
Thank you. like to conclude with three shlokas from Guru Ashtaka. Composed by Shankaracharya himself. We really have to wonder if a Jagadguru says Tatakim, 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 Tatakim Manaschenna Lagnam Guru Randri Padme. If your mind is not riveted, fixed on the lotus feet of your Guru, Tatakim, then what? He doesn't have an answer. If he has not got an answer, none else can. There is no gati, there is no madhi. So Guru is pivoted. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, all that is said in this. But it is so suggestive. Nothing is vocal. He says, Shariram Surupam. You have a wonderful body, the figure is so beautiful, attractive personae. Tathava Kalatram. And you have the spouse also matching you. Very beautiful. Yashaschar Chitram. And what to speak about your glory? It is glorious. Char Chitram Yashaha. Dhanam Meru Tulyam. Like the Mount Meru, you have amassed wealth. Heaps and heaps of money you have. But Manaschenna Lagnam Guru Rangri Padme Tatakim 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 Tatakim. Shadangadi Vedo Shiksha Vyakaranam Chandah Jyotishin Niruktam Tatha Kalpascheti Shadangadi Vedasyavam Manishinaha. The six angas. Along with the six angas, you have studied all the Vedas. Shadangadi Vedo Mukhe Shastra Vidya. Open your mouth and Shastra comes out Pukar Pukar. Kavitvadi Gadhyam Supadhyam Karoti. Look at the flow. Kavitvadi Gadhyam Supadhyam Karoti. Repeat. Manaschenna Lagnam Guru Rangri Padme Tatakim. Videsheshu Manya Swadesheshu Dhanya Sadachara Vritteshu Matto. You have a good conduct, no doubt. Sadachara Vritteshu Matto Na Chanyaha. You are not an ordinary person and you don't look down upon others. But only positive. The lacuna is your mind is not fixed on the Guru. You don't consider it the Guru. Guru Rangri Padme Manaschenna Lagnam Tatakim Tatakim. In different bhavas he said, Tatakim Tatakim. So with these three shlokas, let me continue.
Shariram Surupam Tathava
यशश्चारुचित्रं धनं मे भूतुर् शरीरं सुरूपं तथा वदनत्रं यशश्चारुचित्रं धनं मे
ഇന്നത്തെ ഈ വൈകുന്നേരത്തിന് ഇത്രയും വിജ്ഞാനപ്രദമായിട്ടുള്ളതും ഇത്രയും അനുഭവമാക്കിയിട്ടുള്ളൊരു സംഗീതം തന്നതിന് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വളരെയധികം സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്. മാഡത്തിനോട് ഡോക്ടർ സത്യവതിയോട് വളരെയധികം ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് കൃതാർത്ഥതയുണ്ട്. എന്താണ് പറയേണ്ടത് എനിക്കറിയില്ല. അത്രയും ഒരു വല്ലാത്തൊരു അനുഭവമായിരുന്നു. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഇങ്ങനെ വളരെ ഒരു വിജ്ഞാന ചെറിയൊരു സദസ്സിൽ ഇത്രയും മനോഹരമായിട്ട് ഇത്രയും വിജ്ഞാനപ്രദമായിട്ട് നോളജബിൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ളൊരു പരിപാടി ഞാൻ അവതരിപ്പിച്ചതിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് വളരെയധികം സന്തോഷമുണ്ട്. ഞാൻ എല്ലാവരുടെയും പേരിൽ നന്ദി പറയുകയാണ്, നമസ്കാരം പറയുകയാണ് എല്ലാവർക്കും.
Maya, 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 Maya.